Hello my friends. In a new story from the Children's Island Stories, we will tell him the story of the wolf and the bird. Please don't forget to subscribe and like in the channel so we can complete the stories. Let's begin.
Once upon a time, a wolf, well known for his cruelty, received his punishment for being greedy. As he was devouring a lamb, a tiny sharp bone stuck in his throat. And from that day on, he could swallow nothing except sips of water, which neither soothed the pain nor appeased his hunger. Though he tried every remedy he knew, he was unable to dislodge the bone. In despair, he started to ask everyone he knew for help. But, scared of his awful reputation, folk made excuses to avoid the wolf and would have nothing to do with him. One day, from behind his barred door, the fox said, "I am not well, so I can't open the door. But I think you ought to have a word with the crane down at the end of the big pond. Folks say she is the best doctor around here." Without much hope and feeling sorry for himself, the wolf went to see the crane. And when he got to her house, he tried his best to be pleasant. "Mrs. Crane, I am told you are very much clever. If you can help me, I will give you a rich reward." At first, the crane, well aware of the wolf's reputation, was alarmed, though also proud at the idea of treating such a famous patient. And, attracted too by the promise of a reward, she said she would see what she could do. The wolf opened wide his huge mouth. The crane shuddered at the thought of peering inside the red jaws with their sharp fangs. But plucking up her courage, she said, "Now, please keep your mouth wide open, or I won't be able to remove the bone." And she poked her long beak down the wolf's throat and pulled out the little bone. "There, you can close your mouth again. You will be able to swallow whatever you like now." The wolf could hardly believe it. His throat was clear at last. Extremely delighted, the crane said, "See how clever I am? You didn't feel a thing. I whipped out that nasty bone with my long beak. And as for my reward..." The wolf interrupted with a smile. "Reward? What reward? You ought to be grateful that I didn't bite your head off while it was down my throat. You should give me a reward for sparing your life." Seeing the wolf's bloodshot eyes, the crane realized she was now in danger. What more could she expect from such a wicked wolf? And she vowed that from then on, she would only treat patients too harmless ever to threaten her. Long time ago, there lived a partridge under a tree. The partridge one day decided to go to the fields and indulge itself in the food there. But it did not return for many days, as it found the fields a good source of food. In the meantime, a hare came along one day and occupied the same dwelling which the partridge used to live in. The partridge, however, returned from the fields having grown plump from the food. It wanted to claim the dwelling for itself. A fight ensued, and the hare was saying that the dwelling belonged to whoever occupied it. Then, they both decided to contact a supposedly learned cat. So, one day, they both approached the cat with their problem. The cat, which was actually a hypocrite who earned his livelihood by posing as a priest, decided to take advantage of this situation. On hearing the partridge and the hare from a distance, it said, "Sorry, I can't hear you, dear, from that far a distance because of an old age. Don't worry, I mean no harm to you. Come closer and both of you tell me your stories." They were fooled into coming near, and as soon as he could lay his hands on both of them, he killed them both and had a meal. Story moral: when two people fight, the third mediator has the advantage.